Well, cue the fire. I have some good news and I have some bad news. We are going to start off with the good news because we're done. This channel's done with bad news. All right, good news. The second largest city over there on the other side of the pond, the United Kingdom just declared bankruptcy. And the crowd goes wild. We need more good news. Okay, I got more good news. You guys are flooding me with emails. Link in the description if you want to send me whatever you want to send me. On the banks, the accounts disappearing. But 9 times out of 10, the stuff you guys send me, and it's juicy too. These are emails. I'm like, I can't say that. You're the president and he's the CEO. You might get in trouble. And I realize it's 1 a.m. You're probably intoxicated. I'm not going with it. Citizens Bank was the last one. Ninja went with it. I'm like, you can have it, man. Enjoy. But anyways, ominous beige book warns consumers. That would be you and I, because we like to consume. We're done. Okay, we have completely exhausted the savings, which it showed you in the charts. Your savings are now gone. Now, what comes next? Well, now you have those things like, missed a payment. Missed another payment. You're not making your payments, which I showed yesterday. Student loan payments, those aren't being made. Then what's next is you don't make that car payment. Then they come get your car. Oh, by the way, the repo market. Yes, also from your emails. That's blowing up. Those of you that got into collecting vehicles that are not being paid for is through the roof. So trying to find a tow truck nowadays, good luck. It was like trying to find a truck to get out of California a couple years ago. Also, in regards to California, I heard Beverly Hills is a ghost town. You guys voted that in. Good job. I'll show you. Looting everything. It's all gone. Poof. It's all gone. But anyways, exhausted savings as recession mentions soar to 5-year high. Ooh, Joey B's not going to like that one. I wonder how they're going to handle these narratives, right? When everything's horrible, they're like, well, we can only go up. Only up from here. U.S. consumers paid for July. How'd you guys do that? Well, the July spending spree by burning through $150 billion in savings. Because YOLO, right? You only live once. We got this. Usually it's credit, it's savings, credit card, and then default. And in a debt-based system, that's how it always ends, right? Lots of debt, okay. We're going to tax you, default. Because at some point, you can only squeeze so much money out of each and every one of you. And then you have those little, the U.S. Budget deficit, $2 trillion. Actual. That's the true one. See, you can't, and as like a consumer, you cannot take in more than what you could squeeze out of people. And definitely not when you're over budget by $2 trillion. With all the shenanigans, I think we're going to see a lot more of things like this coming in from CNN, the most untrusted news source and network here. Hear why. Can you hear why Britain's? I was not an English major. Hear why Britain's second largest city has declared itself bankrupt. Kaput. Well, we know because it can't go on like this. I mean, we're going to go bankrupt. They're going to go bankrupt. Everyone goes bankrupt. Yay. Here's what the banksters are reporting. From different districts had mixed experiences with growth. I know the one Citizen Bank, that one of the emails I got, he's like, yeah, we normally do, you know, X amount, I don't know, 70 loans a year. This year, I think we're at 2. Strong growth, you know, year over year. Most indicated that consumer loan balances rose. Okay, probably credit card. And some districts reported higher delinquency on customer credit lines. Now for some of the good news, that inflation, beige book, inflation be dipping. So you guys seem less worried about inflation right now. Currently more worried about, look at those bars. What are you guys searching for? Slow. And how about that dirty R word, recession? Oh, whoa, we're picking up. We hit a 15. I'm going to say that beats, let's go all the way back. 2023, 2020, 2021. Look at that. Well, that's because we were in one. And that was a 7 in 1920, right? Woo! Yeah, we're fine. Everything's fine. See, just good news. Just good news today. Everything's fine. Look, you guys are even paying more. This is great news. The share of Americans paying over $2,000 a month for a mortgage has nearly tripled in 2 years. Go Joey B. I mean, that just means more people are making more money. It's just not you. Look how much the government's making. Like, look, this is great. U.S. federal budget deficit projected to double this year. Great. I mean, you guys should probably get a job in government because it looks like they're getting all the money. I mean, I also have another solution. Start a business, okay? All right, and figure out these things called expenses. Let's just take, for example, when I was a teacher, let's just pretend, I'm just using hypotheticals, I made $100,000. And the tax rate's 38%. What's 38%? Well, you're like, oh, but you gotta make $250 for the 38. Just rock with me on this one. So they take 38%, plus you're in California, another 15%. What are we at? 38, 48, we're over half. You lose half of your money. That's because you don't have any expenses. But if I were to make this and I'm like, hey, babe, we should go to China and figure out how this is made. Oh, we can expense all that? Sure. So hypothetically, if I can expense $100,000 minus $100,000, how much do I have to pay tax? Well, it'd be zero. Or in other words, I get to keep my money that I made. Yes. Anywho, so that's one thing. And then the second thing is trade it. Investors are forgetting the pain before the pivot. Okay, there's going to be a reason for the pivot. What is that? Well, that's because everything just went to hell in a handbasket. Like maybe your trade on that that iPhone, Apple. Actually, I did. That was in my options course. And no, that has not been released yet. I'm currently filming it. But it's important for you guys to know you can make money when the market goes up. You can make it when it goes down. And my squirrel moment, since it just hit the screen, here is Apple. Could you, based on my indicators, have predicted where price action or where the price is going? Let's see. You have a 7, 8, and 9. Get ready for the swing trade. Where do you put that in? One candle closed right there. You write it from that point all the way up until that point, 7%. And then a 9 count comes on. What do you do? Go the other way. The cool thing in my course is I give you step by step. I go like, this is where we're going. Like Apple, this was received on, it was a sell to open. You're like, sell? How do you sell to open? Well, I'll show you. On 9/5 at 12 o'clock. On Tuesday, 9/5 at 12 o'clock, Apple was almost at $190. Now, where are we at there? Where are we at? Steve? 174. Actually, this used to be my favorite company when Steve was at the helm. No longer. 176 now. We're getting a little bit of a bounce. But if you want to learn how to make your digits go higher, 60% off, link in the description. Start with my swing trading course. And you plug in all my indicators. But if you're already an expert, get the indicators. And then you have confirmation. Look. See that? See how like it twists? So nice and pretty. You're like, yep, that was good. Now guess what? We're gonna twist on the other side to give you more confirmation. Just let this thing print money. Be like the government. You guys print money, make digits go bigger, and they print money, making digits go bigger. It's a lose-lose situation. Regional banks may need to sell $63 billion in bonds under rule. And this is because the government is printing money. How do they do that? They say, hey, anyone, I'm sorry, stuff on my desk. I have a contract. No, you're not going to do that. I got a share of Tesla. It's a bond. They create bonds out of thin air, right? And they're like, does anyone want to buy these bonds? And then all of your banks said, yes, we will buy them, but we don't have any money, but we have people that keep making deposits in the bank. And they said, sure, you can go ahead and use those. And they have. And they bought the bond market at the highest ever with your money. And now it's at the lowest ever. And now they have to sell. So basically, your banks are buying high and selling low. Because Jerome or the governments are saying, you guys need to have more cash. You're like, they're like, wait, we have to buy bonds. No, you not now. Now you need cash. So now they got to sell all of the bonds at an all-time low, possibly pushing yields higher. And that's just one side of the coin. The banks are just, they're screwed like a light bulb. U.S. regional banks may need to raise significant amounts of additional debt to comply with new regulatory requirements. But the extra capital might not be enough. Yeah, it won't. It's all upside. It's all broke. It's gone. This is it. Your last leg to prevent future failures, according to research published Wednesday. As if the banks are not already insolvent, which they more than likely are. Now they're having to sell. Now it's like, we got to post all of our losses. Can we please not? Nope, you got to do it. 18 regional lenders might need $63 billion of new holding company debt to comply with rules. The Federal Deposit Insurance Company, which has nothing. F-dick, right? What you name your company? The Federal Reserve and the Office of the Comptroller. Can you just call it a controller? Why the P? Why have to screw my brain like that? Of the currency, according to notes, a note by Bloomberg Intelligent analyst Arnold and Nick, the regulations were drafted by the three agencies to safeguard financial institutions. Okay. Just FYI, the banks, man, they are between a rock and another rock, and then a rock on top. Not catching any breaks. Regulators have been warning banks. We're warning you about commercial real estate. Look at all that $21 trillion you have on your books. It's upside down, along with the bond market upside down, deposits upside, everything's upside down. And then, you know, the Fed's like, we need some more. In 2015, the country's banking regulators joined together to warn that high concentrations of commercial mortgages and poor risk management put banks at a greater risk or of loss or of failure or all the above. I kind of have to chuckle and giggle a little bit when people think that the banks are okay. The banks are not okay. Nothing is okay. It's all just borrowed time. The elites and powers at be just love this. And for some reason, the people and the sheeple keep voting for it. They're like, no, this is great. You've seen Gucci. Skylar wears a lot of it. Unprosecuted crime. And I know the cops out here. I know I'm in LA. I have lots of cop friends. And they're like, yeah, we can't do anything. Our hands are tied, which is crazy. Who's tying those hands, right? Just follow the trail. And it usually leads to money. Economic woes turns Beverly Hills into a ghost town. And I'd love to show you like the videos of the only people that are here are the ones that are just walking in and walking out with stuff for free. Look, something like that, but I can't show you because then YouTube goes, no, 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 no. So instead of showing you, I just tell you, and then I tell you how to fix it and how to profit from it. Hey, if they're on one side making it, you should be on the other. So hopefully you guys are taking advantage of everything that I set down. From my courses to starting businesses, and then you do your own thing. Also, my apology about Apple and the NASDAQ. Couldn't have saw that one coming, now could we? But anywho, love you guys. Hit something, a like, a subscribe, a share, whatever you want, and I will see you tomorrow.